Hey guys, welcome to Muncher Movies. We're completely engulfed in Game of Thrones fever over here and hope you're loving the videos that we've been putting out. Don't forget to hit subscribe so you can keep up with the madness that has been Game of Thrones the final season. In this video, we're going to be talking about something that the show has built up in the past few seasons, and that's Dany losing control over what she thought was rightfully hers. The love of her followers, the power to rid the world of tyranny, and finally, an ironclad claim to the Iron Throne. After watching this latest episode, The Last of the Starks, it is all but clear that Dany is spiraling out of control and showing more and more hints of the madness and anger that had engulfed her grandfather, the infamous Mad King Aerys Targaryen. First, let's look into why Dany is put into this spot by the show's creators. But before that, let's also give our respect to the creators in their smarts with playing with the audiences and subverting expectations when they feel like it's an obvious plot point. All of this Dany losing control and going down the Mad King path has been a bit contrived, so we won't be surprised to see her character do something completely unexpected. That being said, it's something that seems to be too strong to subvert and might play a major part in bringing her character arc to a close. Ever since Dany joined up forces with Jon, she hasn't had much going for her. First, she loses her dragon to the Night King, then she finds out that her lover is actually her nephew and has a stronger claim to the throne. That prickly point actually plays out to devastating effect in this episode, where she first begs Jon not to reveal that secret to anyone, lol, and then commands him to keep it under wraps. Before that though, all her quote-unquote children, that is the Dothraki and the Unsullied, was swept aside in the Battle of Winterfell in the previous episode. Grey Worm does mention that half the Unsullied are still alive, but given what we saw from the first scene of the Battle of Winterfell, we're pretty sure that there are not many Dothraki around. She also lost her close confidant and aide Jorah Mormont, and without him, it seemingly felt that Grey Worm and Missandei were the only two people she could completely trust. In this episode, we see Jon and Ser Davos ride to King's Landing, while Dany and her dragons sail to Dragonstone, but are ambushed by Euron and a lot of scorpion arrows, which effectively kill Rhaegal in 3 blows. Strike 2, Dany, we just have 1 dragon left now. In the scenes that follow, we see Varys and Tyrion, who now know Jon's true identity, discussing who they think should be the rightful ruler, with Varys convinced that it should be Jon. Therefore, we see her close advisors also waver in their support of the Queen. Varys and Tyrion also advise her not to attack King's Landing, but to command Cersei and her forces to surrender, which Dany agrees with, thinking that if the people know that Cersei refused, at least her conscience is clear when she burns King's Landing to the ground. Unfortunately, the plan, as always, backfires. Cersei refuses to surrender, and in the process, executes Missandei in front of Dany and Grey Worm. This was the final nail in the coffin. Missandei's last words, or word in this case, also give us a hint of what to expect. Dracarys, which means dragonfire in High Valyrian, could also mean a call to arms for Dany to burn everything to the ground. The show has now built Dany up to be a replica of her grandfather and burn everything in sight till the Iron Throne is hers. I wonder how Jon would take to that. Let us know if you think Dany is on her way to becoming the Mad Queen, and what other theories you would like us to explore by writing in the comments below. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Till next time,